in my lifetime, I'm 51, five times, and I've spent my whole life in New York, five times people have been predicting the death of New York and the death of cities. And every time they've been not just wrong, they've been profoundly wrong. And through crisis, New York and other big cities have innovated and made themselves better. And that's been happening not just for 51 years, but for hundreds of years.
But even though companies are increasingly saying as a perk to hiring, and we're hearing this in massive surveys, employment surveys, that now a perk is you can work anywhere you want, that is going to, we know people are leaving jobs if they don't have that flexibility. That doesn't change things at
all? You're also having companies say that if you leave, your salary is going to be adjusted to reflect the cost of living where you're moving to. So I don't think we're going to fully understand those demographic trends until you see where people end up on the other side of COVID. And again, if we were together and you looked outside my window or you went to Central Park, I don't think you would be doubting the future of New York. And the same would be true if we were in Paris, London, Tokyo, Toronto, or Doha.
Bruce, come on in on this, because I do wonder, like logistics centers, data centers, is that more attractive? Is there something that's more attractive now that we've gone through the pandemic?
What Chuck Khaled should have said about his residential is he had some projects in London that he could sell to people that are listening to this call. But first, but I'll do his pitch for him. Look, here's what I would say. There's no doubt the one sector, and we've been investing significant amounts of money in it over the past 7-8 years. Data centers didn't exist really 15 years ago. There's enormous amounts of money going into the data center business, and it's going to continue for a long period of time. But when you look at the amount of capital in that area, or in life science, or in some of these niche areas, they're phenomenal investments, and they have been great investments, and they will be in the future, but they're relatively small dollars globally. And so, yes, they are great investments, but the true value investments today, and where big money can be put to work and where significant value can be made, is buying in these great cities today when people have a different, more pessimistic view of them.